Hi everybody, today I'm gonna do a little tutorial on how to make a stovetop, how to mount it, how to fix it, and how to wick it, of course, because a lot of people have been asking me, how the hell do you wick a stovetop? And I'm getting a little tired of typing it and answering it, so now I'm gonna make a tutorial on it. There are some existing already. I don't know why you guys didn't find that out yet, but one thing about stovetop, I believe stovetop is so underrated, it's crazy. Once it's well wicked, that thing is the thing to go for flavors, because the way the coil is made, the way it gets in contact with the wick, you get the flavors, and you also get really decent clouds. Let's go down and I will show you guys how to do these things. Hey everybody, we're back. Alright, so now what we will need to make that stovetop, it's actually this here. First of all, I made that little wire. Well, actually, it's one tiny piece of scrap wire, because when you do stovetop, you don't need as long as other build, let's say. Because most of the time, a stovetop, it's a single coil to start with. And so this is the wire I will use. And what we will need is some cotton for when we'll wick it, because a lot of people been asking me, how the hell do you wick a stovetop? So I'll show you how to wick a stovetop. We will need a pair of long nose, and a pair of long nose with little flat part here, because we will need that bill later on. A little later on I'll show you why. We will need some tweezers. Well, this little screwdriver, it's an Allen key for my Addy. We will need some scissors, and very important, we will need some E-tape. And of course, a mod. So let's start. What we will need now is that pair of long nose and that piece of wire that we that you pre-made. So what you will do, let me zoom a little bit. Alright, so what you're gonna need to do is put it in where the flat part is, not where it cuts, but where the flat part is. You're gonna put it right in the center and leave it sticking out on the other side like this. Once it's like this, right in the center, we will take that E-tape, and you'll understand. If you get some of those long nose that locks like actually a vice grip, I haven't found some yet, but the reason why I like to use this E-tape, I'll show you why. What you do is, you're just gonna secure it tight, just so it doesn't move while you work on it. Alright, and you make it tight. And what's happening with E-tape, it's elastic, alright? Since it's elastic, you can pull on it like this to just adjust it right here, okay? So now, what you're gonna need to do, this part, you're gonna bend it 45 degrees, alright? So it looks pretty much like this. So what you're gonna need to do now, it's slowly, all right? You don't force it too much. You make it do a nice little loop like this, all right? Then you're gonna tight it up, but as you tight it up, you hold your thumb right in the center of that thing, all right? And then you tight it up as you push with your thumb on it, all right? This will make this happen. Alright, but we need to make it tighter than this, so we're gonna need to pull a little more on it. All now, once it has started, then you just, as you put your thumb on top of the middle of the build, you always keep your thumb on it because that's what keep the coil tight on it. And you do, I say about 3 to 4 loops, 5 if you want, if it fits, because that's what's happening. It's more loops you do, bigger in the diameter it gets. And it's pretty much like when you do a normal coil. When you do a normal coil, you can't do too many loops because it's gonna stick out the side, you know? So with this one, we'll try to doing 1, 2, 3, I'm at like 4 loops now. We can leave it right here. So now what we have, it's this, see? And with that lead left over, as I said before, you can pull a bit on it and then just put it right in a jaw. Like, just because I'm doing a video, it's giving me a hard time. But anyway, what you do, you put it back in like this. Once it's in, you pull on it and you make it tight. Sorry, I'm off camera right now because I'm gonna make it tighter. And there's no magic behind this, it's just like I'm trying to pull it. All right, so once I have it done, right, I can take the scissors and cut this. That's gonna release your coil. All right, so that's what we're getting. All right, it's okay if it kind of unswirl, that's fine, because we're gonna fix it once it's on the Addy. All right, so next step, we're gonna need the Addy. I'm gonna use the El Cabron for this one. For stovetops, I like to use those single hole in the center post hole, because we just use one coil. So now, what you're gonna need to do, it's super simple. What I do is, I usually, let's say, mount it like this. So the negative lead goes on the negative side. It doesn't come by under, it gets on it by over. Some people do it by under, I don't mind. It's just like, I think it looks a lot prettier when it's over. And it's easier to fix it too after. Alright, so now you mount it. You put it in, and when you put it in, you let it, let's say, stick out about 1 to 2 millimeter from the center post. And now, unlike other builds that I showed before, this one, I tight the negative first. You'll understand why. All right, I tied it tight. Once it's, I'm just gonna center the center it a little bit. You see, I got like a tiny little space in it. That's what I need now. All right, there's only the negative that it's tight. The center post, it's not tight yet. The reason why is, you're gonna take your long nose. Yeah, got those lovely little long nose surgical doctor tool. And what I do is, I just go grab it, and as you can see, as I go, I'm tightening it. You see? Once it's tight enough, I'm gonna hold it and then tight the center post. Center post might turn a little bit because it's a little weak. All right, once it's there, this is what we're getting. All right, it's not fixed yet, it's all right, we'll do this in one moment. Once this is done, you can take your little cutters and cut the leads. All righty then, So now, first you're gonna make sure that nothing's touching before you spark it. Even if it's not perfect, it's as soon as you'll spark it, it'll warm up, you'll be able to fix it. But the thing with stovetop, guys, it's once you coil it, it's very important that you don't make it too tight, so that way they get on top of each other. Alright, there's always gonna need a little space between each little row. Alright, now let's spark this. The coil is moving, I used a lot of ribbon. When you use ribbon, the first time you spark it, you're gonna see the ribbon singe. It's really cool. Like it's moving, it's alive. Yeah. Yeah, that looks pretty nice, and the glow is really nice too. That's like I said, on stovetop, if it touch, you'll see it's gonna make a little hot spot. And it's cool because you can fix this just by pulling on one of them, because you see the whole thing change. Nice. And by the way, guys, I said it before, I think stovetops are really underrated. Because stovetop, with the surface of element that touch the wick, because the wick will be behind the coil, between the post and the coil. So I think, honestly, for flavors, these fuckers are crazy. Okay, so now, this is, it's not super perfect because I didn't take my time to do it, because I gotta make it quick for the video. So see, it glows up really nice, and the back, I still have the space for it. All right, so now, how you wick a stovetop? You're gonna take your cotton sheets, you're gonna cut yourself some nice little stick. I don't always do this, but this one I will split it. I'll do the same as if I was going to put it into something. And now I go in between. Well, it's up to you. All you gotta do for this is to make sure all the back of it, it's nice and tight, a little tighter than the traditional coil that people know. This gotta be tighter because when cotton gets dry, kinda shrink. And when it shrink, it stick away from the coil. So what you gotta do is to wrap it around. The way I do this one is I just like roll it around the center post wire. And you gotta make sure too that as you go, push the wick into the coil. You'll see all those fiber gets in between and everything. That's what you need, right? I got one piece. And also another way you can do, it's like this. You take like a whole bunch of little pieces like this. You just like fluff it up. You put it behind it and you just stuff it. anywhere. Doesn't matter where it goes, you just stuff that cotton everywhere in the back. Right now I use the pad, but when I use when I do stovetop, most of the time I will use some fiber freaks. I like fiber freaks because you get nice and long fibers. It doesn't seem to singe as much when it gets dry, so it stays close to the coil the whole way. And as you go, so like other people, they like to wet their cotton so they can place it a little easier. I do that after, and most of the time I don't have to fix anything else. But you see guys, this is how you wick a stovetop. Alright. So now let's juice this. When am I gonna use? Okay, I'm gonna use this Wonder Worm from Charlie Chip Dust. Yeah, I love the Charlie Chip Dust products. They're amazing. I get them from Liquid E-Juice, one of my official sponsor. They have amazing liquids, guys. They have American liquids, which is something pretty expensive if you gotta order it. All right. So now, you see, right now I'm using, this is pretty low, I'm pretty sure. Pretty high, I mean. I'm gonna put it on something else in that mod, because I use that mod just to build on. I'm gonna put it on the X cube. So we have a 0.25 ohm coil. You see this one works a lot better. Let's see this. That works good, but it's because it's dry. But I'll put some more juice on, and maybe another time I will show you how to wick it a different way. When you wick it the other way, you get the dragon wick effect. See, oh, the flavors out of this. And I know what you guys are thinking when you see those those little stovetop coils. Anyway, you can use this for pretty much anything. It's a flavor coil. I hope you liked it. I'm Ghost Vapor, and this is how I do my stovetop and my wicking. So we'll see you back up there. Yeah, we're back, guys. Okay, so I got one thing to say. It's this is how I do my stovetop, how I do my things. Please guys, if you like it, share it, subscribe. Please subscribe, because more subscriber I'll have, more stuff I will do, crazier the tutorial, the tricks, the video I will do, because I'm working on a lot of things right now, and a lot of things are coming up pretty soon. Yeah. So one thing else, I got these out now, the Ghost Vapor coils. These one new got four builds coming with it, and it's going out for about like $45. If you're in US or stuff like that, you're gonna have to pay the shipping. I got bigger, I got some with 8 in it. I will have a whole bunch of stuff coming up soon. I will have some t-shirts, I will have stickers, I will have liquid. So anyway, you guys, I'll show you how the hell this thing works. But like I said before, stovetop are so underrated. I think this is the thing for flavors. Very, very tasty. Yeah, this is the way to go, guys. If you never built one, try one. The way the coil hits the wick makes the flavor pops out. It's crazy. So yeah. Hope you enjoy, guys, and see you next time for another tutorial. Peace.